Hello everyone, welcome to my channel once again. In this video we are going to install fog lamp for my Volkswagen Polo 2019 model. This trendline model actually, which doesn't have fog lamps. So in this video we are going to install a fog lamp and I'm going to give the budget for that. So when I thought to install the fog lamps, I just reached a Volkswagen dealership and asked for the quote. They quoted actually around 22k for this. So I thought it's like a bit high, so I thought to install it myself. So I ordered a few things in AliExpress and I did a wiring in the service center itself. Let me show you the wiring, how they did. Actually the wiring is coming from all the way from here to till here. So here it is separating into three sides actually. So this is going to your horn and this is going to main light. Nothing but a headlamp, so it is coming here actually. And for Trendline models there will be empty holder here, so that if you want fog lamps in future you can connect from here. So what they did actually, they did a wiring from here. Even you can do that, but still it is in warranty, right? So I didn't touch anything, so I went to the showroom. So what they did actually, here they connected some wires and all the way down. So with this holder actually they did a wiring. So this holder is there on the both side. So for this holder and wiring, everything they actually billed me around 3,100 rupees. So we just completed wiring for this fog lamp installation. The second thing what we have to do is actually we need to change this switch. In Trendline model there won't be a dedicated connection for fog lamps in this switch. So actually what you need to do in this existing Highline and Trendline models, you need to pull this switch in one step. Then fog lamps will be switched on. In the second step, rear fog lamps will be switched on. But in this switch we don't have that facility, so we need to order a switch. So what I did actually, I just ordered a switch with fog lamp function in AliExpress, which cost me around 600 rupees. So this is the switch actually, you can see the difference. So we are going to install this switch in this video. And the price difference between the showroom switch and the AliExpress is huge actually. The showroom they quoted me around 7000 rupees, but I bought this for 600 rupees in AliExpress. So now I'm going to remove this existing switch. I'm going to install the new switch here. So for removing this switch is very simple actually. You need to long press and turn into right side and just try to pull outside. So that's it. And here you need to take out this plug. It's a bit heavy actually. Let me try. So we just successfully removed that existing switch. Now we are going to install a new switch here. So this is the new switch which is having the fog lamp functionality. So I'm going to insert it into the existing plug point and I'm going to press it. That's it. So in the same way you just put it inside and try to long press. So that's it. So for fog lamp functionality, you need to enable the seat lights first and try to pull once. So now the connection will be established for the fog lamps. If you are pulling one more time, this will be established for rear fog lamps. So now we will go to the front side and we will try to install the fog lamps. And third thing is the fog lamp. So this fog lamp I bought it in AliExpress for 2100 I guess. This is Euro spec model. The difference between Indian and Eurospec is having two bulbs actually. In Indian models there won't be two bulbs, this will be a fake one. So in Indian models cornering lights everything will be enabled in the fog lamp only, but in Eurospec it is totally different. So in future I may have some chance to explore this bulb as well. But for now there will be only one connectivity for the fog lamp. And the fog lamp which includes bulb as well. So the overall cost including bulb is around 2100 only. So This is the LED kit which I'm going to install inside the fog lamp, and this bulb type is H7, and here you can see two filaments actually. There is one speciality in this LED. This LED can change into three colors as per your driving style, which is pure yellow and normal horizon color, and third one is pure white. So when this can be enabled when you switch on and off the fog lamps. So on each switch on and switch off, there will be a color change. So this is H7 type. So and from AliExpress, I bought this for around 1300. So now I'm going to remove this halogen bulb from the fog lamp assembly, and I'm going to install this H7 LED bulb into this fog lamp. Clockwise. I just installed it. Here you can see inside. So on both sides I'm going to do the same. I just connected these two fog lamps into the plug point. This on the right and this is on the left side. So let's see how it is works. Just place my mobile in one place. I'm going to switch on the fog lamps. So just look at it, how it is glowing. These LEDs are too good. In the highway you can use it. So even in the evening time you can see the illumination. And fourth item is fog lamp grill. So this is a existing grill actually, I didn't buy a new one. I asked the dealership, but they said around both grills will cost around 4000. So instead of buying new one, I just did a cost cutting. So I just made the cut as per the fog lamp size. I'm going to use the same one. So it is pretty good actually, and it is barely noticeable. So for these corners, I'm going to give some nice stickers or going to do something. So now the grill, fog lamp, everything is in place. So I'm going to put everything and assemble back together. So let's see. So on both sides it sat very well, so you can see, and the cut is barely usable. Let me close the bonnet and I'll switch on the fog lamps one more time. So now it is giving a clean look. So let me switch on my fog lamp one more time. So now I'll show you whatever I have done for the past 6 months. Actually, I bought this car on last year of October, I guess. So till now, whatever I have done with this car, I'll explain now. So first go with the bumper. So in the bumper, I stick the carbon fiber vinyl. So it gives me the nice style and bold look. And I stick the GT logo here. And the fog lamp, obviously, now. And in the bonnet, there is a scope just for a new purpose, not anything functional here. And these are rubber straps. And I painted my mirror in black. I did myself. And the alloys I didn't touch till now because my tire is healthy. So once the tire is going away, then I'll change it. And the rear side, I just installed a GT spoiler, which cost me around 10,000. And I kept a GT logo here as well, and I removed the existing Polo. And I have a rear garnish here in the tiki. Let's check out inside. And even the door side, I sticked it, so it won't be having any dents in future. So inside now, the switch is replaced and the steering is leather wrapped. It's custom, actually. I stitched myself, and above that stitching, I just kept a plastic here, so which gives you a nice feeling. And I just replaced my 2-tin Bluetooth basic stereo from my Skoda Rapid to here, and which is working fine. And yeah, that's it. And guys, one more thing, this just to inform you that in the next video I'm going to do some OBD11 tweaks in this car. So nothing but I'm going to enable few features in the system level. I'm going to enable few features which is not having in Highline as well. So in next video we are going to see this one. This is a OBD device, actually. So with this device, just plug into the car and connect with the mobile, and whatever the coding you want to do, you can do that. So it will reflect in your VCM unit, so you can change anything, whatever you want in the hardware. So let's see in the next video.